Tony Abbott is not even in government yet, but already he's flexing his muscles. He has sacked the former Victorian Labor Premier Steve Bracks as Australia's Consul-General in New York. Our political editor Hugh Rimmington joins us now. And Hugh, how is Labor taking this?
Well, Sandra, they're not happy about it. Labor people have got a lot on their minds at the moment. They've got a leadership vacuum that they have to resolve. There are bitter arguments within the party as to whether Kevin Rudd should stay in Parliament or quietly leave. The Steve Bracks thing has cut right through that. Labor people are angry. There is talk of lawyers.
When he came to power, Kevin Rudd affirmed former Howard Minister Amanda Vanstone as ambassador to Rome. He gave other plum jobs to Peter Costello, Tim Fisher, Brendan Nelson. From Tony Abbott, no such courtesies for Labor Party elder Steve Bracks, sacked overnight as Consul General in New York before he even got there.
I think it's a petty and vindictive act.
It could end up with a legal claim.
I will not cause the taxpayers any undue expense. Just whatever my rights are.
On the Labor leadership, senior party sources expect Bill Shorten will be a candidate. Former Deputy Prime Minister Anthony Albanese has significant support. Sources have told 10 today he is not ruling out standing in a contest.
Kevin Rudd remains a divisive figure within Labor, some former cabinet ministers publicly denouncing him in the last 24 hours, others saying he saved the party, and the criticisms of him are outrageous.
10 News has been told Mr. Rudd intends to honour his promise to stay on in Parliament. Tony Abbott, meanwhile, continues to prepare for his official takeover next week. In the campaign, the coalition slammed Kevin Rudd's PNG refugee plan as an election fix that was unravelling by the day. But now the election's been won.
We will make the most of the arrangements which the former government put in place with PNG.
The Prime Minister-elect also signalled his initial official residence will be Kirribilli House on Sydney Harbour because of renovations at the lodge.
It may well not be possible to move into the lodge for a considerable period of time.
Not a bad option.
Well, someone who knows both the Lodge and Kirribilli House very well, the former Prime Minister, now former MP Julia Gillard, has kept radio silence ever since she was toppled from the Prime Ministership. That will end later this month. She will be appearing at the Sydney Opera House in conversation with the feminist author Anne Summers. It is said to be her only appearance in Sydney for the rest of the year. Tickets will be $60 or so, Sandra.
Hugh Rimmington there with the latest from politics and Canberra. Thank you.